Well, talk about exciting. Good day, everybody. Connor McIver, Remax, Paris911.com. Of course, our main site, scvnest.com, local agent headquartered in Santa Clarita Valley. Santa Clarita Valley's realtor, as we like to say. This is going to be a pre-Thanksgiving real estate update. Now, we actually took a Facebook live video that I produced a couple days ago. We plugged that into our main homepage there at SCV Nest. So please, when you have a chance, check it out, because we do give some intel on the local market and where we happen to be this week or where we will be here coming up this next year. Now, of course, everybody knows, if you're listening to our broadcast, you follow us on Facebook, we do have an election that had occurred very recently. Donald Trump was elected, and the stock market got a little panicked, everybody got a little worried. You know, realistically, at the end of the day, whenever Democrats get elected, Republicans get elected, all the systems pretty much are going to stay the same, at least for a while. That's the same thing that's going to occur. Now, interest rates aren't going to go haywire, more than likely until sometime into next year, and probably not really even haywire at that. Maybe changing up just a little, but it's not going to be crazy. Don't forget, as far as the housing community goes, real estate resale, new home builders, there are a lot of vendors, a lot of people whose businesses depend on that continuing to work. And the best markets for those are those markets that are continuing at a healthy pace. Right now, I'll give you an example. All of Southern California, folks, and you can get all this data here at scvnest.com. Go to scvnest.com. Go down right below the Facebook video, the live video that I posted there on the page, and you'll see under top areas and neighborhoods, bank-owned foreclosure properties, real estate-owned properties, we were into the thousands of real estate resale data that was showing real estate-owned properties and foreclosure properties for sale, and that was in all of Southern California. As of this morning, as of this video here, middle of November, November 15th, 2016, 156 foreclosure properties, bank-owned properties, currently on the market for sale. That's it. You click on it, you'll see they're all over Southern California. There is no direct location. There is no hub of foreclosure activity. They're spread out. They're just spread out like a shotgun pattern all over Southern California. Then we move into the other individual cities out here. After we cover the main, Santa Clarita Valley, 788 real estate listings that happen to be currently on the market here in the Santa Clarita Valley cities. That's going to include Acton all the way through Valencia. So Acton, it's going to include Castaic, Canyon Country, Newhall, Saugus, Stevenson Ranch, and Valencia. Whenever we talk to our real estate buyers, and I have an appointment this morning to speak with somebody over the phone, it's something called a crash course on real estate. And it's so important because I like to consider myself, as far as real estate goes at least, your first advisor, talking about real estate, talking about not just buying that house to live in, but looking at that original, the very first home as an investment opportunity, something that's going to be the one you hold on to and potentially rent, use it as leverage to buy number two, number three, number four, moving through your life cycle. By the time you get done purchasing real estate, you start in your mid-20s, you could realistically have 5 to 8 different assets that are all financing themselves, who you're having somebody else pay your mortgage. This is where I like to start that process when I have buyers come into our office. Did a blog post somewhat related to that, talking about why you need to get educated when wanting to buy real estate. Top 3 reasons you can get that, scvnest.com/blog. And of course, first is going to be me covering the basics when we talk. And when looking at real estate buyers, right now with the internet being what it is, real estate syndication websites being what they are, some of the questions buyers have are pertaining to where do I find the real listings, because before they meet me, a lot of times they've gotten a little bit into trouble where they've reached out to somebody, turns out that that wasn't the agent for them, or they reached out and inquired online about a property, and then all of a sudden Their email fills up with spam from all these different agents. Their phone rings off the hook. It's very uncomfortable. It's a very strange process. So people really don't understand where they need to go and what they should be downloading onto their phones, what apps. We have all of those tools, and everything leads back to yours truly, Connor McIver, and of course, Paris McIver. We will not spam, trade, sell, nor give away anybody's personal information. SCVNest.com. If you want to get the app, MyScVApp.com, check it out. You can download that. Now, as far as basics go, what should a buyer be looking out for when searching for homes online? These are some of the questions that we cover in the Crash Course on Real Estate. Where are the best deals to be found in any real estate market? What about foreclosures, bank-owned homes? Again, talked about that. That inventory is really, really slacking. Maybe 1% of the total real estate for sale market is bank-owned foreclosures, distressed in nature. And that is indicative of a healthy real estate market. Are those special deal rate websites really being up front? So we do talk about that. How to get in trouble online, of course, and how to stay out of trouble. Educating the real estate buyer. This is kind of an intermediate, but it's also taken care of at the same time, about 45 minutes or an hour. What is the difference between different types of real estate lenders? Because there are a few, right? Credit unions, oh my gosh, we get calls all the time. Is this a great deal? Should we use them? Again, you have to look at those numbers, and we cover that. How can I be assured my bank is giving me the best loan? There's that. What about my credit union? Are they really on my side? So we talk about that as well. Where do I see what my interest rate will be, and can that change? This is kind of a little bit of bait and switch stuff here that we cover in our Crash Course in Real Estate. How much does it cost to buy a home, and do I have to pay my real estate agent? Great question, and the answer is to no is going to be no as far as paying your agent representing you as a home buyer. There are closing costs, however. So we talk about that. So the more advanced course, and this is kind of where people in the industry, predatory people, really don't like, but this is what we talk about with our real estate clients, and it's very, very helpful, and it best protects you. How to get less than a full price offer accepted, how to buy a home, have the seller pay your closing costs. Is there a way to get lenders to compete for your loan business? And then here's something else we talk about, because you see these websites. What's the real estate game with those online top agent, realty review, real estate referral, real estate lending competing websites? I explain that to our clients and talk about what those are and why they've been built and how come they're so successful. How to use your new savvy power to leverage real estate wanting to buy a home. When is it time to fire your real estate agent or your real estate lender? These are things that we put up yesterday talking about it, talking about the real estate process, what buyers need to know. And you'll be able to see all of that, scvnest.com/blog. Again, reach out to me when you're ready, 888-SCV-NEST. Did a blog post also at the same location about toll-free numbers for you millennials out there, because I asked my son, my eldest, if he knew what a toll-free number was. Clueless. It's good for you to know, even though you're not saving money by calling. It does make it easy to remember, 888-SCV-NEST. Reach out to me. I'm Connor McIver. Thank you for tuning in to housingradio.com. It's always a pleasure, and this is going to be your mid-November update. We will talk soon, probably after Thanksgiving. But please, tune in. You can always see the newest Facebook Live videos we put up there at the homepage, scvnest.com, and paris911.com. Have a fantastic day. We will talk to you soon. Connor McIver, over and out.